before we're done, obviously this type of program, these experiences that we all agree were life-changing, don't happen by accident. So we want to take the opportunity, Rafael, to recognize you and to provide you with some sincere thanks for shepherding us over the city for the last 3 weeks. And I believe Dwayne has an input. Yep.
Come on up, Rafael.
Thank you.
One of the things that, you know, we've all just sacrificed our situations this year is really temporary. I mean, us being away from home, but we've experienced something with people that's in a lifelong situation, and our effort to just give back a little is just that, just to give a little. You've demonstrated a great deal of dedication over the years, and so on behalf of June 17 CIP for participants recognizes Rafael in grateful appreciation for your service and dedication. In addition, we've got our class has what we call one of our challenge coins. It's a partnership coin. You said, you know, you sometimes 50-50 UPS and 50-50 industry. Maybe we don't know which side, front, back.
Right.
So I think you're 100% industry, 100% UPS. And on this partnership coin, our people make the difference is on one side. And the Casey quote that we've seen several times, determined people working together can do anything. So thank you, my brother Fred.
Innovation, inclusion,
integration, so we got some level iteration, but I'm gonna use some of yours. And I also thank Scott and Tony and Henry and the entire fact that UPS as an organization gets behind this, and we're coming up on our 50th year next year, so that's exceptionally exciting. And then of course I wanna thank Raphael and Diane, because they are the backbone and they hold this whole project together in a way that's special, that's exceptional. And that often goes above and beyond. I mean, you know, we were out to dinner last night, but this is kind of in addition to the work they do every day that's really vitally important. So I stand here humbled because I think this partnership does the impossible. When you're a leader of an organization, you wish that you could kind of stop the world, kind of go up 30,000 feet and kind of look at the impact that it has on the people you serve, look at the impact that it has on the staff, and look at the impact that it has on the stakeholders that come in. And where this program does the impossible, it's interesting enough, it speeds everything up, but yet it still gives us that same opportunity to kind of look within and look at the work we do through different sets of eyes, and it helps us and expands our thinking and our capacity to do the work. So without exception, the other predictable thing is that you make us a better organization for spending time here with us, and you inspire us to do better things. So we thank you for that from the bottom of our heart. And another thing that's predictable is I often throw some rhymes together and throw some words. So not many of you know, but I got some bars. And each group it is special. And so I build on this every year. And so I apologize if this goes a little long, but you guys are inspirational. And I'm going to, without further ado, I will read the June 2017 version of A Box of Chocolates. Like UPS brand chocolates. Get it? Yes. All right. So you open your minds. That's page two. Okay. We know you love logistics, but what about linguistics? Just sit back and listen to the way that I skip this. My rhymes so sweet like cotton candy, sharp and with rhythm, like our lawyer friend Andy. I bust out of here, make it look easy. It's kind of happy here, so enjoy the breezy. A journey indeed, from the mundane to the explicit, impossible to predict, and no way you can script it. If your memory fails and you feel like you missed it, just get a picture from Eric. I'm sure that he clicked it. We knew from day one that this group would not fail, and we're really good. You can leave our friend Craig in jail. It's because he was scared, for those of you who don't know. You came from wearing brown, from out of town, and spent almost a month of your life with us here downtown. You're on the clock, that may be true, but you leave your life, your family, and your comfy home too. Like a box of chocolates, not sure what we'll get, June 2017 might be the best yet. Local, national, and even worldwide, you represent the worldwide, bite the big apple to see what's inside. 8 men and 2 ladies, this group was much more, so we opened our hearts when we opened the door. A little like tourists with eyes open wide, UPS airdrops you smack on the Lower East Side. Like that chocolate you bite, it's just kind of odd. I'm sure there were parts of this trip that were hard. The pace of the schedule that created the days, the basketball lesson from kids half your age. The steel curtain came down when Dwayne popped his tendon. Our hearts out to you and we hope that you're mending. Mind, body, and soul, we know that you gave it your all. We didn't call you on your ringer and you didn't fight that bad call. Jim Casey's Rangers were the test to complete. You gave your hearts, minds, and heart to Henry Street. On Andrew, on Eric, on Daniel, Joel, and Charlene. On Elizabeth, on Stuart, on Craig, Johnny, and Dwayne. Sorry, I had to make Dwayne mind the show. You came fired up with wide open hearts. This group would be different, we knew from the start. No social dilemma, too big or too small. You opened your minds to try to tackle them all. Unemployment, homelessness, and poverty most abject. You even concocted a plan to plaster ads on the projects. I'm sure parts of your trip were not that pretty, but from the very first moment you gave yourselves to this city. We aim to change your life and your whole disposition. How's that, Johnny, for a value proposition? With a propensity for intensity and no fear of the density, you've given the CIP reputation a whole new identity. Without a doubt, you hit the streets with a spirit so inspired, but thinking about what defines this group made me simply kind of tired. Walking and walking and walking, you clocked thousands of miles. For a pretty motley crew, you took every step with style. With a spirit in your heart so strong you could taste it, we enjoyed every minute and every meal. Not a moment or breadcrumb was wasted. The food and the eating, the meals big enough for Fred Flintstone. You ate your way around New York as long as it had no bones. Your commitment always crystal clear. Your loyalty unflinching. questionable though, because you bought your coffee in support of the competition. You bought the coffee from Think Coffee, that's
right. Right.
We'll let it slide this time, and our mind will not perplex unless you send us care packages and you use FedEx. We feel that you've already sent the love and have done so from the start. Signed, sealed, delivered. It's a smack in the heart. The fight we fight is hard, the struggle tough to endure. And now ask when we, if we make a difference, we can answer, that's for sure. So please remember the moment the truth became clear, just what was the meaning of spending time here. It's not just about what Brown can do, but the values that live deep inside of you. For 49 years, we've been sharing this time to change people's lives and to help with the climb, to open a door or to just lend a hand, to become more involved or to just understand. No matter what path, life's a journey we share, it's important to notice and important to care. It's not just to stand there, but to do your part. It's the highest aspiration of the human heart. So we thank you and applaud you for being here and for sharing the work that we hold so dear. Because like a box of chocolates, all Brown and me, your time here at Henry Street was certainly sweet. Thank you so much. In it are a couple of really simple things. One, a Henry Street pin, so you can always keep us near to your heart. And interestingly, second, we got a pound of Henry Street coffee in here. So if you're gonna buy a coffee that's gonna support an organization, you can buy this and not support the competition. And then, unfortunately, because of a technical difficulty, usually we give out thimbles, and because it's a way of acknowledging and thanking you for doing your part. So I have one thimble, and because he was the one that almost made me cry, and because he really left it all on the table, and because he unfortunately hurt himself, but then was tough and hung it out. We have one thimble, and we're gonna give it to you for our friend Dwayne.
Thank you.
Sam's I guess we'll have some lunch for those of us who want to join us with the team, and we'll break from there.